Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is Engine News with the latest updates from the Angular community every week. Angular 21 has been released and it comes with a nice set of features. Here are the main ones. We finally got support for signals in the Angular DevTools. They are working on a component level, so you have to select the component first, activate the signal graph, and then you see all the signals with context information. Signals can be signal, computed, linked signal, and even the effect function is supported. This feature is still experimental, so we don't see the resource as one unit yet, but rather as a collection of multiple signals. You also have the option to name a signal by using the debug name property. In testing, whenever we wanted to set an input property, we had to come up with a wrapper component which simulated the parent component, or we used the component ref set input. Now the testbed's createComponent method has a second parameter for bindings. This supports not only property binding, but also event binding and two-way binding. The HttpClient client, and logically also the HttpResource resource, which uses the HttpClient client under the hood, has received a nice set of power-ups. It now allows us to pass through properties that the native fetch function exposes, such as support for timeout, caching, managing redirects, and more. For AI-assisted development, which hopefully we are all doing right now, the Angular CLI now comes with an MCP server. You need to register it in your IDE, and from that point on, your IDE will use the MCP server whenever it generates Angular code or you ask Angular-specific questions. Sometimes we want to change or assign a value to a property when an event happens. If it's just a one-liner, we can now do that directly in the template, thanks to a syntax extension that supports different types of assignment operators. Given that signals are the way forward and that we should avoid using logic in the template, this is more going to be an edge case. Last but not least, the Angular CLI allows us now also to import image files in TypeScript. These can then, for example, be encoded in Base64 and reused in the template. And that's it. I wish you a nice weekend. See you in the next episode. Goodbye.